What's up, YouTube? This is Too Raw for TV. So in the wake of the NBA's decision to give a relative slap on the wrist to Phoenix Suns owner Robert Sarver, what, in essence, what, a year off with pay and a $40 fine in our world? So NBA Commissioner Adam Silver has been trying to explain why Robert Sarver got such a sweet deal compared to Donald Sterling, who lost his franchise 8 years ago, right? And, you know, it's funny. 8 years ago, Adam Silver was Judge Dredd. You know what I'm saying? I am the law! Now, all of a sudden, he's bumbling Barney Fife. But I am there. I want to suspend him for life. Now, Barney, the owners aren't going to like that. And the board of directors just say no. But I am. No. Now, go pick up Aunt B from church recital. Okay, and you know, This is my take on this right now. I've been thinking about this. I think when it comes to Adam Silver's explanations about Robert Sarver has shown contrition, whereas Donald Sterling did not, I think that's a recent comparison to, say, Deshaun Watson, who has been very adamant that he did nothing wrong. So that's recent in people's minds. So, you know, even though he already missed one season due to circumstances, we all know that Deshaun Watson will be suspended all the way to week 12, right? So I think he's bringing that up as a comparative situation, even though this is the NBA and it's NFL, right? But people can think about that. But this is my thing, man. Adam Silver and the NBA are full of shit, all right? This is what I kind of think, all right? Hear me out. Now, let's go back in time to 2014. Obama was still president, right? Now, at this particular time, there had been a lot of high-profile incidents involving black men and black women being killed in very, to say the least, suspicious circumstances. Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, I can't think of her name right now, but the sister that was most likely murdered by Texas police officers, Sadia, I can't think of her name right now, top of my head, but it's right on the tip of my tongue. But anyway, the mood of black youth at that time, there was a social awakening. We remember it. There was an anger out there that we need some type of justice. And there was a growing consciousness. And here comes the situation with Donald Sterling. Right? Now, never mind the fact that Donald Sterling already was disliked by most of the owners and that the Clippers had been a relative disaster for the 30-plus years he had owned them. I mean, just a disaster. And he had had terrible relationships with a lot of players. They couldn't stand him. So when he got caught on tape saying that, that was a smoking gun. Obviously, that was a smoking gun. But the ingredients were already there for him to have that franchise taken away from him. So that's why Adam Silver was able to saunter in and appear to be strong and decisive in this situation. But now we're in a different situation here, right? We're in a slightly different situation. Adam Silver has been proven to me not to have that type of power. He's not a powerful commissioner. He serves the board of directors, and he serves the interests of the owners. Sauver, despite being a complete, total asshole who needs to have his franchise taken away from him, they feel uncomfortable doing it because these fucking players, they're not the same. These guys today, man, these players, over a decade later, they're not as in tune. They're not as conscious about a lot of this shit, man. Gotta think, man, a lot of the players who were involved and spoke out about Donald Sterling, a lot of them were players that weren't even playing anymore, or they were older players. To me, I put a lot of this on the leadership of the NBA as far as the players is concerned. The leadership. Where's Chris Paul? Well, he's not going to speak because he just got signed a big contract. He's cool. He's cool now. Devin Booker just signed that big extension, wasn't it? So he's cool. So these players, they're in a situation of shit. They're making so much more money. They sold out, man. Let's be honest. A lot of these players have sold the fuck out. The ownership, it sets a bad precedent in their mind because they're the ones that feel like, hey, we enforce the rules, but the rules don't apply to us. We're the elites. So look, we already sacrificed one owner. We can't make it a habit of always sacrificing the owner because, hey, they did something wrong. We're the elites. The rules don't apply to us. And that's the message they gave to Adam Silver. And he's trying to obfuscate. And he's trying to, depending upon who's the crowd, dissemble away as to why they did what they did. This was a move for the elites. And we're in a different environment. We're in a different environment. Sauver, if I'm not mistaken, he has a lot of friends, political friends. He's given to GOP candidates. I believe he's donated to Trump. He is in a position where he knows a lot of dirt. They're afraid of that shit. And at the end of the day, I think those plays, they play a factor. That's why I think the only way you can get Sauver out that motherfucker is it's going to take some of the top people in the NBA to speak out on him. LeBron James, Kevin Durant. Man, fuck Kyrie Irving at this point, man. That dude, I'm just sick of him. Hell, Michael Jordan. Steph Curry. Giannis. It's going to take the upper players, the upper fringe players, Luka Doncic. You know, even though I know he's not American, but still. It's going to take those guys. And I don't know if they're going to do it. I don't know if they're going to do it. And to me, if they don't, this makes them just as culpable as the NFL. It's fucked up. Because you kicked out an owner really for less. You kicked out an owner for less. And no matter how much Adam Silver want to explain away, you got shown as nothing but a figurehead that, you know what I'm saying, that bows down to authority and privilege and, for lack of a better term, white supremacy. Because look, you could talk about, and I know this is an unrelated sport, but Tom Brady never apologized for the football thing. Deflating footballs. I don't remember the Patriots ever apologizing for cheating. So, these excuses are very, very flimsy. Oh, by the way, I never mentioned it. The reason why I'm using this picture of Archie Bunker is because to me, Donald Sterling is season one Archie. Robert Sarver might be season eight Archie. Okay, yeah, season eight Archie Bunker, if you ever watch the show, he's a little bit more enlightened. He don't say as much racist shit as he used to, but he's still a fucking bigot. He is still a racist. They don't change their stripes. Like he told Edith in one of the last episodes, he said, look there, Edith. Now, I done absorbed your women lives there. But some things about me, Edith, ain't gonna change. Oh, it ain't gonna change there, Edith. But Archie, Edith, that's how I feel. He might know now not to say the N-word around the head coach and the GM. Because he got in trouble with that shit with Earl Watson and whoever the fuck was before him. But I don't mean it still ain't in his fucking heart. It still don't mean he don't harbor these things. And it still don't mean that from time to time, a lot of his decisions are based upon his misogyny and his racism. Isn't that the point of penalizing people who are racist? You can have your racist beliefs. You can believe what you want to believe. But you cannot legislate through misogyny and racism. Those are things that's supposed to automatically take your franchise away. Take you away from a position of authority. I mean, what was the point of the Civil Rights Act? They wanted to be able to still be able to use their racism as a weapon. I don't want to hire niggers. I don't want to hire women. I don't believe women should be working. I don't believe in hiring, Mexicans. Or I don't want to hire Latinos. That's the shit that we did away with 50 years ago, 60 years ago. And I'm not saying he ain't hiring on the basis of that because he runs a sports franchise. But don't think that shit don't play a role in why all of a sudden he's hired all these black folk. They don't sit there and look at us and say, oh, well, you know, man, Michael Vick made a big mistake, man, but he's come a long way. We got to give him his props. He's given him, man, Michael Vick has been nothing but a model citizen. No, they don't look at it like that. With him, dogfighting. They're always going to bring it up for the rest of his fucking life. For the rest of his life, Michael Vick is going to be that 25-year-old with cornrows who made a mistake. Not the 42 or 43-year-old who has done so much with his life since then and has paid his debt to society. So don't give me that bullshit about, oh, it's sophomoric or he's grown. I don't want to hear that shit. Take his franchise away from his goddamn ass.